Hey, what's up? I thought it'd be a cool idea to show you my favorite apps that I use. I'm gonna go through them very quickly. Let's go. One Keyboard, it allows you to connect to Apple TV or your iPhone and type with your keyboard from your computer or even another computer. One Password, Password Manager, love it. I have a video on that. AirFoil, it allows you to make a radio station so you can transmit from one device and pick it up on all of your devices. So kind of a hacky stereo sound surround system for your home. I love to use it when I'm cleaning. Alfred, there's a whole video on that. Airy, it allows you to download YouTube videos in high quality, the ones that have the proper rights. AnyDesk is a software where you can remote into other computers. I have someone remote into you. I use it a lot whenever I'm helping friends out. Atom, it's a text editor used for coding, but I use it for all sorts of things. Audacity, it's a free audio editing software. Pretty powerful. Bartender, it customizes the top menu bar, so if you have a lot of menu bar icons, it doesn't look messy. BetterTouchTool, also one of my favorites. I have videos on that. Carbon Copy Cloner, you basically clone your hard drive. Whenever I'm setting up a new computer, I clone the hard drive right after. That way I never have to do a full setup again. CleanMyMacX, this is really good for cleaning up your computer and uninstalling applications and finding all the hidden files. If you buy the free version, you can go to uninstall and just see where the files are and delete them manually. It's a little gamification, and they have some menus that show up all the time and bother me, so I make sure to close everything out after I use it. It is valuable though. DaisyDisk is an application where you can visualize how much space things are taking up and identify big areas where you can clean up. Dropbox, I'll do a video on that later. EasyFind is a program that is just kind of like Mac Search in the Finder, but much more powerful. Flux, it kind of fixes the blue screen on your computer. FontExplorerX, it's for managing fonts, way better than FontBook. The UI is a little weird, but it's the best there is. Gemini 2, it finds duplicate folders. Whenever I'm sorting through my duplicates, I put one set in one folder, one set in the second, and then check them out, and you can choose to remove all duplicates from one particular path. Giphy Capture, it's a really cool free screen recording program. HandBrake, it converts videos to smaller sizes if you want to convert a movie for your iPhone or something. iWriter, it's just a pure text editing program. To compose, it's really cool. iMazing, it backs up your iPhone and you're able to go to your older backups and search through the content. Whenever I back up my iPhone, like every month or so, I'll delete all my messages from my phone. That way it's a little bit more secure if something happens. And I can always go back and search for my messages. Kind of annoying, but secure. iShredder is an application that will totally delete your iPhone and write over it multiple times. And it's very secure if you need to get rid of an iPhone or give it to someone else. iTerm 2 is a terminal program. I like it because it's more customizable than terminal. And you can also add margins on the edges, so it's a little bit cooler. Keka makes zip files. It has the weirdest little icon, but it's super simple. Whenever I want to make a zip file, rather than right clicking and going to create archive, I just do F11 with Alfred, open with, and then open it with Keka, and then it'll automatically create a zip file. And then it also creates segmented zip files. So if you have a 3 gigabyte file and you need to send it over the internet, you make segmented zips, 25 megabytes each, which is faster to upload to the internet. And then whenever the person opens the first zip, it puts them all together. Little Snitch is a program that monitors all incoming connections from your computer and any program. You can accept or deny them. It's kind of annoying in the beginning, but it's a really secure way to see what's talking to the internet. NeoFinder, it helps you index your hard drives. I have a video on that. Quicken, also have a video on that. SizeUp, it's a window management program, so you can do left, right, top, down, corner. You get the point. I have a video on that too. SmallCubed, it's a plugin for mail which allows you to send later and make fancier signatures and stuff. Subtitles, whenever you acquire a movie legally, you just open the movie file with this program and it'll download the subtitles. Pretty cool. Things, it's a task management program. I'll do a video on that later. Super cool. Kind of expensive, but totally worth it. Transmit, it's an FTP program or file transfer protocol for uploading stuff to the internet or your web server. TunnelBear, it's a VPN. It's super easy to use and you can use it on your phone too. Time, it's a time tracking software, which has a lot of keyboard shortcuts. Time 2 is better than Time 3. It's a new version. Time 3 still has more shortcuts to set up. And finally, Typinator, it's a text expansion program that I use and I did a video on. Kind of a long video, but if you have any questions, you can email me at hello@theproductivityshop.co or join the Productivity Shop Slack channel. See you later.